Okay, hello. This is requested here, and this is Violent Femmes. That's what I think it's pronounced, and it's called Blister in the Sun. And yeah, so somebody requested this. I said I've never heard of them, so let's give them a shot. And the song was just the first song I saw, and I saw it had a bunch of views and stuff, so I guess it must be good. And I saw a little bit of background on the band, and I guess they're sort of a folk punk band, it says. So yeah, I'm just trying to see, or I'm gonna see what's all about. And yeah, not too long of a song or anything, so I'm intrigued. Let's go. Okay, so yeah, Blister in the Sun, Violent Femmes. This was quite the song. Yeah, like I said, I've never heard like of this band or the song. And yeah, so this is a very first here, and I liked it. I mean, I love. I'll say right off the bat, I love the drums. The song, I see it's from 1983, but to me, it has like a 60s feel. I don't know why, but with the drums especially, I just hear like what I'm hearing is like Beach Boy vibes. Maybe it's just like the orange in the background and all that stuff. It's all just kind of, I don't know, kind of upbeat kind of vibes. But yeah, the Beach Boys, like, especially on like, I can't remember the song now, but maybe like Little Deuce Coupe, or it was like Little Saint Nick or something like that from the Beach Boys. And just the drums in that just remind me of the drums in this. They just come pounding through. And I really like drums, if you've seen other reactions I've done. So yeah, I just love that part. And also his voice, I think his name is Gordon, I want to say, from here, the main vocalist. And yeah, Gordon Gano. So yeah, his voice, especially when he whispered and stuff, that was pretty I don't know, kind of funny to me as well, kind of like ASMR, you know. And yeah, so I guess that's it for right there. So on the bio of the song, it says this is a classic song with a classic riff. The lyrics are about heroin abuse and getting rejected by girls. Well, all right, you know, a normal teenage frustration tune from Violent Femmes. In 2007, Richie filed a lawsuit against Gano for band earnings and ownership rights stemming from Gano's approval for the song "Blister in the Sun" to be used in a Winnie's commercial. Once again, the band broke up. So Richie, I'm just gonna go down because I don't know who Richie. So Brian Ritchie was the backing vocals. Gordon Gano wrote the song, it says. Victor DeLorenzo was on drums, so shout out to him. And also, Brian Ritchie's the bass guitarist, and Gordon Gano was the guitarist of the song. So, yeah, I'm learning here now. This is pretty good. So, yeah, like I said, I love the song. It was just a very different kind of a feel, and I'm here for it. So, yeah. All right, so in the first verse, it says, when I'm walking out, I strut my stuff. Yeah, and I'm so strung out. I'm high as a kite. I just might stop to check you out. So it says, Gano is strutting along without a care in the world because he is doped up on heroin. He's loose and feeling like nothing can bring him down from his high. This carefree attitude of the narrator highlights the difficulty of those around him having to deal with drug addiction. So it says, my girlfriend, she's at the end. She's starting to cry. Note how bouncing motif has Beatles Day Tripper vibe. So yeah, with that saying, it's kind of a Beatles vibe, which they were from the 60s. So yeah, that's what I'm saying. And there's kind of a 60s vibe to it, and I like it. So then we go on. Let me go on. Like a blister in the sun. Let me go on. Big hands. I know you're the one. So it says, we imagine a bulbous sore growing unchecked until it bursts from exposure. The narrator's addiction is growing and festering. The effects are visible to all, and it seems he's headed for disaster. The sickening imagery is much like the opening in Langston Hughes's A Dream Deferred. Then we go on again. So it says, this line is written from a girl's perspective. It says, on VH1, Gordon Gano claimed that he liked a popular girl in high school. Who doesn't? And it says, but she would date him. One time she made fun of his small hands. Oh, well. Also, people who deal with drugs are sometimes referred to as big hands. Doctors have noticed over the years that heroin users often have puffy, swollen hands. So, yeah, that's basically it there. And then we have the second verse. It says, body and beats, I stain my sheets. I don't even know why. And it says, in an interview with Village Voice, Blister in the Sun is not about masturbation, a talk with violent femmes. All right. Gano explicitly rejected the masturbation thesis. Okay, so that's what I kind of thought right off the bat with the stains. So he said, I don't think that there's a whole lot to understand with the lyrics. In fact, it was maybe 10 or 15 years later when somebody was asking me about the song. And I said, well, you know what that song's about. I'm like, no, what are you talking about? Well, everybody knows you wrote it. I'm like, what? And they told me that the song was about masturbation. I'd never thought of that. This line could also be possibly a reference to withdrawal, with sweat being the substance straining, staining his sheets, or even how heroin withdrawals increase the likelihood of wet dreams. So, yeah, apparently it's not about masturbation, so don't say it is, because it's not. And then we go on. And the first verse repeats again, so we already did that in the annotation. And then we go down to the second verse again, the first verse again, and then we have the chorus and the song. So yeah, it's all the same stuff. And that's what I was going to say. He repeated the lines at the end there, and obviously he like said it very quietly, which was pretty funny. And I see there's a video here of a breakdown of Violent Femmes, and there's two guys there, and I want to say it's probably Gordon Gano and Brian Ritchie probably. I don't know if they're still together or what's going on there with the band, but maybe I'll even just look up right now. Why not? Because I'm kind of intrigued, and the song was just something else. I don't know why, but I'm probably going to listen to some more of this band now because it's pretty, I like this song a lot. So it says, are an American folk punk band from Milwaukee. So I guess they're still going. 1980 to 87. 88 to 89 and 2013 to present. So yeah, I guess they're still together now. And I don't know what happened. It says somebody sued. They sued each other or something like that. I don't know what came of that. But obviously, they're together again now. I don't know who's in the band. But yeah, I guess that's it. yeah, a little short song and a lot of rambling. So anyway, thanks for watching, I guess. Thanks for liking and subscribing and commenting and all that stuff. Really appreciate the requests. And I guess that's it. All right. So yeah, stay hydrated, all that stuff, and I'll see you guys again soon.